40.
45 and 31 on mic.
Very good.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to the February 14th, 2024 edition of the New Canaan Town Council meeting. So we'll call the meeting to order. And we will start with the Pledge of Allegiance.
If I could please have I'm Keith Feather, the Scoutmaster of Troop 45 here in New Canaan, and tonight we're joined by both Troop 45 and Troop 31. If I could have you guys come forward. So it's our pleasure to be here, and we've actually graduated a couple of Eagle Scouts recently. If you visited the Bristow Bird Sanctuary, you'll see there's new QR codes there talking about trees or the rebuilt wall at the Mather Farm. So we are active in the community and encourage any boys of scouting age, come stop by and say hello.
Okay.
Jack, if I could get our senior patrol leader, please lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
That's on.
Scout salute.
I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Well, it is Valentine's Day, so we'll leave you with that. Thank you very much for the opportunity. We appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you. Watch out for that cord there. Thanks. Bye.
Luke, you want to give him a little razzle dazzle? You're an Eagle Scout too? Give him a little something.
Yeah. So congratulations to all the scouts here. That's a huge, huge accomplishment to become, as you're walking out, to become an Eagle Scout. Me and my three brothers are all Eagle Scouts. We were in scouting our whole lives, and it's near and dear to my heart. So congratulations. It's a huge, monumental success. So congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Luke, this is Eric.
I'm on Zoom. I join you in congratulating all Eagle Scouts. I'm one of three in our family as well. My two brothers and I are Eagle Scouts, and my dad was a Scoutmaster at Troop 70 at St. Mark's for 20 years. So congratulations to anybody who puts in that effort.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm going to do the roll call.
Yep. Are these working now?
Rita?
Here.
Tom Butterworth?
Here.
Janet Fons?
Here.
Luke Kaufman?
Here.
Mike Mora?
Here.
Maria Norton?
Here.
Kimberly Norton?
Here.
Hillary Orman?
Here.
Christina Ross? Here. Eric Thunen?
Here.
Penny Young?
Here.
Jennifer Zonis?
Here.
Thank you. Everybody's here.
Okay, we'll now call the meeting to order. Move on to number two on the agenda. Minutes, approval of the minutes for the regular meeting on January 17th, 2024. Can we have a motion to approve the minutes? So move.
I have an amendment.
When do I note any corrections?
Once we open, we approve the motion and then we open it to the second.
Okay,
so Tom,
thanks.
Tom made the motion?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, anybody second? No, that's it. No seconds?
Oh, second.
They have their mouth full.
Who seconded?
Not sure. I did. Oh, or whatever.
All in favor of a motion? Discussion? Aye. Anybody have any points they want to raise about the...
I it's not a substantive point. It's just a typo, and I'm not going to go nits and nats on commas and apostrophes, but under the appointment section, third paragraph, talking about Mary Cody's appointment, on the second line, it says Ms. Young made the motion to approve the Ms. Cody. You just need to remove the.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
Other comments?
No.
Okay.
Under the commentary about Health and Human Services, the statement that Ms. Norton highlighted that the Health and Human Services Department's proposed budget presented was raised by 299. No, it was not raised. It was increased to.
Yeah. Okay.
Very good.
Or just simply is.
Okay.
Is to 299. That's, you don't really need to put all the qualifiers to, because then you don't know what referencing back what it was. Okay. So just said it is 299.
Okay. I would appreciate if there are any other corrections in the future, just send them to me prior to the meeting and they'll be done. Thank you.
They need to be acknowledged by others, though, so that they know what the changes are.
Okay.
Thank you.
Any further changes? Okay. Are we prepared to vote to approve the minutes of the regular meeting on January 17th, 2024? Everybody ready?
Yes. As amended.
All in favor?
Aye.
It's unanimous. The motion passes.
Thank you.
We'll move on to item agenda number 3, public comments about the agenda. Any public comments?
We have one public comment. Do you want to speak?
Roy, did you want to speak? Or?
Oh.
Put your name on the list.
It's, yeah, you have 2 minutes.
Do you want to see? Yeah, come up to the table, please.
It's 12 o'clock, yeah, please.
It's going to be running.
It walks slow. I wish the Boy Scouts were there. You know, not if we're talking about Boy Scouts.
It's not. Yesterday was the day, snow day, so they're not working.
They're not working.
Yeah, they can hear it. These boxes are picking up.
Oh, okay. No, I just want to say Monday night we had a celebration at the Greenwich Council. We held a Eagle Scout Court of Honor was held to Kate Tucker, our first female Eagle Scout of the Greenwich Council.
Wow. Nice. So, amazing.
I wanted to challenge these boys. I mean, it's a pretty good honor for us. I mean, and it was attended by Ryan and Hector Zeno, the state rep that was instrumental in getting us $250,000 to fix our bridge at the Seton camp that was washed out by Ida. So,
nice.
I'm on a clock now. I don't want to bother everybody, but I just felt I wanted to make some comments at the direction that the audit committee is going. I mean, just to reiterate, you know, I'm an active auditor. I'm PCAOB inspected twice. No deficiencies. AICPA national peer review. National, not state. No deficiencies. I'm an active SEC auditor. I'm a forensic auditor and an expert witness. And I'm on a lot of committees. Here's what I want to say. I handed it out to people, you on the town council, the memo that I wrote in 2012, which I was instrumental in forming an audit committee. Steve Call and the town attorney requested that I join them in 2012, 13, Penny was there. At all of the subcommittee meetings. And I got a lot of questions that they directed at me to answer on how to form the committee and what the rules and regulations are. So I was involved in that. And I feel like it's not a child, but it's something I was interested in. My concern is that an audit committee, by definition, scope, appearance, and practice has to be independent. Otherwise, it doesn't function. In my consideration, our audit committee is not independent. Not. When you have certain elected officials that are also, let's say, have an interest because they're vendors, and it doesn't matter if you sign a non-disclosure or whatever, and I'm not saying there's anything wrong. But when that person or people who have a bias nominate and or vote on the members of an audit committee, how are they going to be independent?
They're not independent.
Minutes. And that's my concern.
Roy. No, I respect you. It's over 2 minutes, okay? You gotta stop. It's over 2 minutes, okay?
Oh, I did that already?
It's quick, believe me, I know. Oh, so I'm in the hot seat all the time. It's more than 2 minutes, so please. So you got to respect the rules. Roy, come on.
It's a recommendation.
Roy, please, I'm asking you, please respect our rules.
Mike, just a recommendation. We should have an independent body selecting the nominees of an audit committee.
All right. Thank you, Roy.
That's what I appreciate. I think we should do.
Okay. Thank you,
Roy. So it's independent. I didn't know I talk so slow. Okay. Happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Valentine's Day. Thank you, Roy.
Okay. Any other comments in the gallery or here, Tucker? Any other comments? That's it? Okay. Moving forward to item number four on the agenda, Daycare Center of New Canaan. The approval of a resolution concerning the Daycare Center of New Canaan as follows, and we're not going to have a five-minute presentation, so come on up.
Well, Sue's here. This is, maybe I can help with this. We have Sue Paris here from the Daycare Center of New Canaan, Bart Krola, who many of you might know, couldn't be here tonight. So Sue and she have worked together. How long have you worked together?
I've been there 25 years.
A long time. Right. So this resolution that's in your agenda must be read and approved by the town council anytime there's a change of administration. This is this resolution with the daycare center. So it's in here. It's just a process formality, kind of a technicality issue. So we just ask that you read it for the minutes. And Sue is here to answer any questions that Sue wasn't prepared to make any kind of presentation. It's pretty straightforward.
Can I just ask for the benefit of everybody to say where the daycare center is located and how many children?
We're at 156 South Avenue. Some of you know. So we're attached to the back of the schoolhouse apartments. We serve 90 children. Wow. 45 preschool, 45 school.
Thank you.
Wow. 50.
Yeah. Okay, so would someone like to make the motion?
I'll move it.
Second. So you want to make the formal motion, Penny?
Make a motion to accept the resolution as posted in our called a meeting. Do I have to read the whole resolution?
You know what? Let's just read it just to be.
Okay. Be it resolved that the first selectman, Deanna L. Carlson, is empowered to enter into and or amend contractual instruments in the name of and or on behalf of the town of New Canaan with the Connecticut Office of Early Childhood for the Daycare Center of New Canaan program. If such an agreement is offered, and to have the corporate seal affixed to all documents required as a part of any offered agreement.
So every year, Barb will come over and meet with the first selectman and has to sign different documents that go to the state, things like that. So this is just allowing for her to be able to do that.
Good.
Any other discussion or comments?
A bunch waiting here to sign for your approval.
Right.
Okay, so all in favor?
Aye.
Unanimous. Motion passes.
Thanks for coming. Great work. Yes.
Thank you.
Pass that on to Barbara.
Yeah. All three of my kids went there. Fantastic program.
Well, I see some familiar faces. And what a voice
though. Have a great night.
Have a good night. Have a good night.
Thank you.
All right, moving along. Item number five on the agenda, financial update. State of recent financial results by Joshua Kaufman.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for having me.
Hello.
So I'm going to share my screen and try to make this as large as possible so you can see it. One second.
Can't see it on your
iPad. Okay. Well, hopefully you have it accessible in front of you as well. So starting with the revenue, this is the monthly year-to-date financials as of the end of January, January 31st. This marks about 60% through the fiscal year. On the revenue side overall, we're at 96.5% through the budgeted revenue. Up at the top with our main driver, tax collections, they're sitting at 98.4% of what was budgeted. Last year was also exactly 98.4%. We still have about 2.5-ish million to collect. We just had our second tranche in January collected. So we're still seeing some of those trickle in into late January, February, before we kind of see that number fill out. down to building permits. Building permits are right now at 64%, similar to last year, down about 20,000. Projecting out, it's still a little bit early in the fiscal year to really project where we think we'll end up at the end. But it does look like we're on target, hopefully, to hit that 850,000 that was budgeted. Right now, we're in a little bit of a lull, and it picks up in the same way conveyance fees below it pick up towards the end of the year. They're sitting at conveyance fees, that is, at 66% of the 1.5 million that was budgeted. Now, if you kind of look at the curve, end to beginning of fiscal year, it goes down back to up. Hopefully we'll see getting close to 1.5, maybe 1.6 million. On to parking. Parking is sitting at 61% of the 930,000. It's down a little bit from last year, about 65,000. Tickets and meters are pretty much on budget. Right now, parking permits are being worked through, and that's kind of going to fill in some of that gap of revenue that we're kind of looking for. Down to interest on investments, they're at 97% of the 900,000 that was budgeted ahead of last year by 320,000. We obviously know that this year interest on investments has been really a boon to our revenue side of things. As conveyance fees and building permits kind of slope back downwards, interest on investments has been spiking upwards. So obviously we still have 5 months or so after this to go. So we'll see where that ends up. On the other revenues, we're at 84%. Some of the highlights are the municipal revenue sharing was about 73,000 over what was budgeted. Was 233,000. And state property rebate was 73,000 over what was budgeted. Any questions on the revenue side of things?
Questions, anybody?
Looks good.
On to the expenditure side of things. We're at about 52% of what was budgeted. It's pretty much on par with where we were last year and where we would expect to be. Obviously not going over budget. We're in line to meet what was budgeted for fiscal year 24. Nothing really stands out as a major highlight on the expenditure side right now. Any questions overall?
We don't have any questions at all on any of these line items or anything overall.
Okay. Sure. And the excess cost grant, for the Board of Ed, when does that come in?
I think that comes
in. It comes in the end of February and then again in May.
Okay, any other questions? Well, okay. Thank you for this presentation.
You're very welcome.
All right, that concludes item number 5. Item number 6, budget meetings, review and discussion of budget meeting process and calendar. Josh Kaufman.
Sure. So right now we're kind of in the middle of the Board of Finance meetings. We've gone through a couple of the bigger ones, DPW and Recreation, Parks and Rec, and Board of Ed. We have a couple more meetings to go and breaking for a week, and then the vote is on March 3rd. I would definitely advise everyone to kind of rewatch some of the videos. The departments really do a great job of going through either their capital requests and so on. There's a lot to it, so it doesn't hurt to look at that. We're gonna start at the Town Council on March 12th, on Tuesday. Also, we have recently started, we added a button to the website that is just right on the front page, budget documents. You can go on there, find the PDF of the budget book that you should have. You should find all of the up-to-date presentations that the departments have sent in that they go over, so you could flip through those. And I think on the front page of the website, there's also a link to a lot of the recent YouTube meetings, the recordings, so those, they're easily accessible from there as well. But that's kind of where we're at right now, and it's been smooth so far, so hopefully it'll be a smooth one through the end.
I just have a question.
I agree. It's so much better this year with all the everything's in one place. The only one thing I would maybe request is all the videos aren't along the bottom. Like I struggle to find certain videos.
Did you just click all videos?
I did.
They're in chronological order.
Okay. Because
I did.
There are different ways. I guess the problem is there are different ways to search, and it took me a while to get there to figure that out. So I did like two other things. It's not for me.
Yeah.
I figured it out. I just want to make sure it's easy. You know, it's accessible for anybody who wants to see it. And it's so much better, I have to say. I just think it could be a little bit better.
When you go to agendas and yeah. The videos are there. They're in multiple places. So if you were looking for a specific meeting and you knew the date, you would find the date.
It was.
The videos there or on YouTube.
Yeah.
I just don't know. The YouTube channel is set up in such a way, it's like their format, if you will.
Right.
But so the most recent, like five are across the top. And then if you just click on all videos, they're all there. Yeah. But by date. That's the key, by date.
Yeah. It's so much better than last year. So it's a huge improvement. There probably could be a few more tweaks, but I think it's great.
Can you remind us where the button that says all videos, is it right at the top bar?
And is it there's also like channel 79. Is that the one? Because there's also channel 79 videos. So
don't interrupt.
Yeah.
When this is over, we'll go online.
That'd be great.
And I'll just show you on here where they all are so everybody can see it.
Thank you.
Sure.
Yeah.
Josh, I think you said March 3rd for the vote, but I think it's March 7th.
No, it is.
Yeah, I noted that as well.
Sorry about that.
Oh, okay. I just want to make sure I'm not looking at
what date is
March 7th.
Thursday.
Okay.
All right. To amplify a point Josh had made, we're halfway through budget season, approaching that point. And I agree with Josh. I've had the opportunity to nerd out on my car ride home and listen to a lot of the presentations, and I've watched on channel 79 at home. Again, every department head they always knock it out of the park with their presentations. Dr. Lutze was fantastic. They spent hours. Mm-hmm. Tigers people, the parking lectures last night, we were watching Maria. I mean, they always are comprehensive. They know what they're talking about. They know their stuff. The Board of Selectmen did a great job scrubbing the budget. Board of Finance questions are always on the money. Todd and his crew really, really zero in and dig into, really where are the soft areas, if any. So how does that relate to us? Again, to kind of follow up on my points I've been raising about how we'll conduct ourselves in our meetings in March, is that we should all be doing our homework right now. Zoom in, remote in, whatever it is, just get on top of it. Know these budgets, understand, listen to the questions that are being asked. Because every person asks a question, every one of them is a right question to ask. So when it comes to us in March, we're moving forward very, very effectively and efficiently. So now is the time to educate and absorb as much as you possibly can about these budgets so we're not hearing it for the first time. All right. Any other comments for Josh? No? Okay, thank you, Josh. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
All right. So number 7 on the agenda is off. Number 8, committee reports. We'll start with bylaws and ordinances. Anything for bylaws?
Why don't you talk about our baby that got launched the other day?
Oh, the Affordable Housing Committee? Committee, I got it right just now. Yes, so we met for the first time on Monday night. It was a really productive introductory meeting. John Goodwin, who is the former chair of planning and zoning and a member of that planning and zoning forever, practically. We elected him as chair. Chris Wilson is our secretary, vice chair, whichever title he prefers. And Deanna was great, or her selectman Carlson was great in outlining. Deanna was wonderful in outlining what she and therefore the town sort of view as our priorities, which were very much in line with the ordinance that we drafted and passed. And our next, we've agreed to meet the second Monday of every month. And we can have special meetings, obviously, if the need arises. And we're planning to have our next committee meeting be a learning session. So where we have people come and talk to us, maybe Mr. McCarthy, a couple of other people, sorry, I don't have my notes on me right now. But it was very productive. Everybody's very excited to get started. So I think it's going to be hopefully a good and well-run and efficient committee and we get things done. I think everybody definitely knows the priorities and what we need to work on. So that's good. Really impressive committee. Great. Thanks.
Well, great. Thank
and
you.
I think that's all, but I don't know that we have anything pending for bylaws.
I don't. Yeah. Okay. Education. Anything?
I'll just say they met, the Board of Ed met, presented to the Board of Finance on February 6th, and that's probably a good one to watch just to get all the questions and answers. And the Board of Finance really is digging in, so it's worth watching. And they go back to the Board of Finance on March 5th. Mm-hmm. So if Rita sent out an email, if anyone has any questions, now's a good time to send them just to alleviate the burden down the road. Just get them into us and we'll forward them on.
And I just add there, the BOE had a meeting on Monday, and just a couple of things that I thought were really cool to just highlight. They approved a donation for the Sex Hawks Court. I don't know if you are familiar with that, but that's their the playground area, the basketball court that's in back. It's in terrible condition right now, and it's going to be amazing. And so just kudos to the PTC presidents and the folks on getting that, raising the money and getting that started. I think it's going to be fantastic. And I know this is not like, I want to give a quote that they had at the meeting, which I think is fantastic. And it's, play is often talked about as if it were a relief from serious learning. But for children, play is serious learning. Play is really the work of childhood. And that's a quote by Fred Rogers. And I just thought, anyway, it's very, very apropos. They raised $160,000, by the way, for that project. And then the rest of the meeting was really talking about special ed programs, the downtown campus and the SPED programs, the special ed programs that are going on at the, what street is that? I'm sorry.
The new BOE building?
Yeah.
Elm Street.
Elm Street. The Elm Street building. And if you are interested at all in learning more about those programs, they did a great in-depth summary. So definitely check out that video if you're interested at all. It's great work.
Thank you. Okay. Finance and government.
Our committee met with our Board of Finance liaisons and with Josh and Ann to go over their budget. The key drivers, and Eric, please pipe up if you want. What I saw as the key drivers in the increase in their budget really is salaries that are contractual, so there's not much flexibility there. Also an increase in town contributions to the retirement fund, which is also contractually negotiated. So those I saw as the main drivers. Eric, did you have anything that you wanted to add?
No, those were the main drivers I thought as well. And those salary increases were agreed to prior to my joining. So I'm just sort of understanding those. One thing I do want to understand as this whole budget process moves forward, I want to understand a little better how and when decisions are made with respect to capital budgets on bonded versus not bonded expenditures. So I'm going to need a little education there. I'll just reach out to one or more of you and pick your brains. Thanks.
Sure, Eric, anytime. Anything we can do to help to educate you and get you up to speed. Absolutely.
I will say that I continue to be more impressed with Ann and Josh every single time I hear them make a presentation or answer questions or throw out these millions of numbers in front of us. It's incredibly helpful, and they're very thorough and extremely responsive.
Agreed.
Great. Anybody else for finance and government?
Thanks, Eric.
Okay. Health and Human Services?
The HHS committee met last Friday. We had Penny and Jen and Kim and I met with the HHS commission. They reported that the health budget is essentially the same as what was presented to the Board of Selectmen on in December. The human services budget is reduced, or was recommended to be reduced by 50,000. We went through some line items. There was some concern that some agencies that are used to getting the support are may not be in the upcoming budget. So it was recommended that the HHS commission go back, look at their budget, and possibly re-examine where they can ask for an increase. And that is happening, I think, on the 20th. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Yeah, that's correct.
So the commission is meeting again on the 20th, and they will make revised recommendations to the Board of Finance on the 27th, I believe.
Yeah, that's correct, Janet. All
right. So any of you want to chime in?
Yeah, I do. I want to compliment this structure of Board of Finance and Town Council meeting together because it gives us an opportunity from our various perspectives, which are different from one another, be it finance or servicing our citizenry, to really be communicating to one another and understanding those dynamics and coming to an agreed upon position that actually is the best of the best of the two perspectives. By having this ability to get together early, those of us on the Health and Human Services side, we're concerned about some of the way the numbers were arrived at. And so I went to, and it was unfortunate that because of the way the structure was finally formed, that the joint meeting was the day after Health and Human Services actually presented to Board of Finance. So they didn't have the benefit of the combined committee to get before finance. So I asked finance to seriously consider the budget as it was being presented and budget as Health and Human Services has some concerns about in their delivery of services to the community. And so that's when Todd Lavieri said to the Health and Human Services Department, I'd like you to come back on the 27th of February with the budget that you have more thoroughly discussed in within the commission and present budget numbers are what you want. And the rationale for any changes that are being made or would be made from what came out of the Board of Selectmen.
So we should update the budget schedule maybe to reflect that Health and Human Services is coming back.
There's a number of items that departments of the Board of Finance has to come back. So I literally have been updating and I'll send a new one out tomorrow.
Thank you, Tucker.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. It was a great report. Anything else or that it?
Infrastructure and utilities?
No, same. We're done with Health and Human Services. Okay. Infrastructure and utilities.
Rita, you want to update?
Sure. We had two really, I thought, productive meetings it's a joint meeting with the Board of Finance as well as Town Council and meeting with them, Tiger. The first meeting was really reviewing past capital, like the capital projects and just getting an update on where we are with those projects. I thought that was really enlightening. I think that's something we should continue to do and get. We actually talked about getting more regular updates just to understand where we are. And I think that the recap of that really affects kind of the requests that are happening this year coming up, because some of the other projects that didn't get done, they are now on that list of things to do. That affects the bandwidth that we actually have to work with. So it was really good to understand that first. And then the second meeting was understanding the capital projects that are being proposed for fiscal year 2025. So, obviously more to come on that, but I thought it was a really good and productive two meetings just to understand that. Do you have anything to add, Christina?
No, we will have another meeting then to discuss the general budget for that Department of Public Works. But I think it really helped everybody to understand, especially mm-hmm. the newcomers, how much work had been already in the slate for Department of Public Works on capital projects and moving forward. And we also broached the subject of capital versus sustained from the general fund, the project sustained from the general fund. So that conversation has started as well. So
Yeah. If
anybody hasn't watched it, please do so, because I think it'll give you some backdrop on what's coming.
Okay. Land use, recreation, and conservation.
So I'll take that one. So similar to what Rita said, Penny and I met last week with John Howe and with the Board of Finance liaisons, and we had a great meeting. It was great for newcomer like me, just, you know, to hear the projects, the ongoing, and John does a great job. And I don't want to get too much into it because it's actually right there. It's very similar to the presentation he did last night for Board of Finance. So it's good watching. And it seems like just some of the increases are, there's some overtime for coming in early and picking up the trash, some issues that you know you can follow and we can get into about Capo Field. So that's generally where that's going, but he does a great job. And it was really interesting. And just in terms of the commissions, Conservation Commission, I think twice their meeting has been canceled. So our esteemed former colleague, Robin Bates Mason, is yet to be approved as the commissioner, but hopefully that will happen soon. And once that happens, we can have that meeting. And it's been reported in the New Canaanite, but just for those who might have missed it, in terms of Parks and Rec, who met last week, they are not approving yet caffeine and carburetors for June, because the date, I think it was June 6th, it was, or 7th, it was a bit too early, and it seemed to be coinciding with the opening of the Banco pool. So it seemed like a lot going on and maybe traffic. So, but they did approve October 20th, yeah, 18th, somewhere in October for the next one. And a new interesting update, if you didn't already read it, is that their representative from Zumbucks seemed to take input, I don't know from which town committee, but that this year they're going to charge a registration fee, I think in the $20-$25 range, and then that money is going to go 100% to the Waveney Park Conservancy. Right. So that's a nice development. And then they approved, it was in the news today, there's going to be a second annual Carriage Barn Arts Festival. So that's it.
Is that a registration fee for the vehicles that are coming in?
Yes, I'm sorry. For the public? Oh, I'm so sorry. Yes, just for the vehicle to be registered. Yeah.
And did they project that would reduce participation?
Is
that one of the reasons they're doing it?
No. Quite honestly, this was Steve Benko tried to have this happen years ago.
Oh yeah.
And you know, for whatever reason, it didn't happen. And we've been having talks with them all along. It's such a successful event that we're trying to figure out how to control it a little bit more, and also. The concerns with the park is we want to make sure the park is always open and available to anybody, whether you're going to caffeine carburetors or not. And so that involves parking and that kind of thing. That's why the June show is a little bit of a question, because there's softball games going on and the dog park and the pool and all of that. So we're still working through their show schedule. But yes, the point is that the registration is a way to control it a little bit more, to know how many cars are coming, to be able to park them in a little bit more of a strategic fashion, that kind of thing.
And as a separate issue, their representative from Zumbuck also just reaffirmed, I think they've done this in the past, but that they will take care of any damage to the lawns.
And, well, yeah, they've always done that.
Yeah.
Okay, anything else? Public safety, I don't have anything.
I do not have anything for public safety. What, do we have a quick update on where we stand with the police building?
Yeah, so it's been fully vacated. They're in the process of essentially ripping the guts out right now. You can see the netting around. There's been, they're totally operational over at the, is that Forest Street right now?
It's the corner.
Yeah. Fully operational. There was some issue with the parking that was happening over there, but I think they've been sorting that out. Other than that, it's moving forward. I'm happy to bring Bill Walbert in if we want to have a more thorough update. If we want, I know we're going for budget season, but right now it's where we have our construction plan, and it's a matter of ripping everything out at this particular point, carting it away, any asbestos that may be there, remediate that, and then start doing the prep work for the building. But it's moving forward. There, we have a fantastic. Operation underway, governing every aspect of that. We have people on the building committee, and I always sing their praises, are just fantastic. Penny Lash has been great. Everyone's great. So we're in excellent hands.
Are we still on track for when it's going to open, right? What's the thought?
No, they're always, you know,
that's
want.
Still squishing.
Way too early. That's
no, yeah, but you have just a target date. Has there been
there's
any
nothing,
delays?
There's
yeah.
No.
Yeah, I mean, they wanted it obviously less than 2 years, but, you know, 18 months. But it's always, like Benny just said, it's
totally
it's
understood.
As you know, your father was a builder.
Oh, no, I know. Yeah.
Like, yeah, you know, done in 18 and then
yeah.
Oh, why is it 36 months later? So
right.
I'd hesitate. But yeah, right, Tucker, there's a presentation tomorrow.
Tomorrow night, they're going to do an update. So what might make
great,
sense is since they're coming tomorrow, then you guys have them in March and you'll get more benefit of the update.
Excellent.
Great.
Okay, so there's nothing else. One thing I do want to circle back on item number 7, since it was off, but I would like to put on a special meeting, hopefully within 2 weeks' time, so we can come back full circle and get these people appointed. So maybe we can throw some dates out and see what works for everybody, just so we keep that on a tight track, okay?
Are we going to do that now, or should we do it?
If we could do it now, I want to, you know, we want to get them appointed, and we want to keep a tight time on that.
Mike, I'm assuming that the two people that are proposing to be appointed, we will get some background information or resumes or something on them in advance.
We have the resumes and any other information, you know, you can
SharePoint.
Request that and we'll get whatever you need. If you want to chat with them, absolutely.
Okay, thanks.
All right.
So much is not available to.
It's on the our tablets for this meeting.
Oh, those two resumes are on for this meeting in the folder.
Yes.
I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm sorry. I will. I skipped by those.
Why weren't they approved tonight?
Why was
that? Since it's on the agenda, just curious.
We wanted to have many of the members wanted just a little more time. Short time range from getting them on Thursday to now wasn't sufficient time to.
Okay.
But there's we've seen their resumes and we just have to do our due diligence and our fiduciary duty to have that discussion and if people want it. So that's all. And that's why I just want a quick turnaround so we can get them back on the point.
Thanks.
What about Wednesday, the 28th?
Well, let me check that.
I would like it to be on a Wednesday just for consistency.
Yeah, that works.
And Tuesday there's a Board of Finance meeting on the 27th. So I wouldn't want to preclude anybody that wants to attend that.
A quick meeting, right?
It'll be a short meeting, so we can
quick.
Work open.
Yeah, I mean,
I just have to check on availability of a room.
Okay, so subject to shoot an email out and we can.
Yeah.
Can we not do it all virtually?
You could.
Yeah. I'm fine doing it all virtually. So
yeah,
you guys are too. Then we can make it super easy.
Sounds good.
But the 28th is a good. Your name for that?
I'm just floating that out as a date. If it's 2 weeks from tonight,
I like it.
I like that. Should give everybody more than sufficient time to.
7 o'clock.
That's fine.
That's
absolutely.
Fine.
Yeah.
If that works, if we can get a Zoom link.
That's not a problem.
We had a hard time getting one for the finance and government.
Yeah,
you run out? Really?
Well, we only have two accounts, and so you can't have more than one meeting.
Got it.
If you need it, I have one. But
well, that's what you can always use your own.
But you don't want that announced publicly.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. You
and would the meeting on the 28th be at 7 p.m. or 6 p.m. or you're not even getting that yet?
7.
Okay.
But it would be quick. I would just, yes.
Absolutely.
Okay.
5 minutes.
Yes.
Okay. Is that it?
With Janet and Tony and Mike.
All right. So subject to the email from Tucker on the logistics, we get a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second. The motion passes.
Nice. All right, let me go.
Valentine's Day.
Thanks for the chocolates. You guys, the chocolates.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Bye.